So I saw a promo on some television show, cable show, and you know how you don't know where you saw what channel anything's on anymore. And the decadent 80s, you know, and they were talking about the music of the 80s. The 70s were decadent, and 60s and the 90s and the 2000s, every decade's decadent. So who deserves that moniker? If anybody does, it's the 70s, the decadent 70s. You know, but I was thinking about the rock music of the 80s, because that's where I started my rock radio career, was in the 80s, 1980 to be exact. So I'm thinking about the great rock songs, you know, and there are a bunch of great rock songs, but nobody thinks of those. They think of the Aha, you know, that kind of thing. That, remember that bit, Take On Me, you know, and Kaja Gugu, Too Shy, you know. All the synthesizer pop music from Britain came over, you know, and the Culture Club and that kind of stuff. And that's what you think about when you think about the 80s. But inside all of that, these great rock songs seep through the soggy, muddy 80s. And here's a list of 10. I got a list. I've thought about it, and I got a list of the 10 greatest rock songs of the 80s. And the first one is number 10, and that's in ascending or descending, because you're getting better, so that's in ascending. But you're descending because you're going from 10 to 1. See what I'm saying? But at any rate, this is my number 10 greatest rock song of the 1980s, and it's Fago Player. What? Now, he did a solo album in 1981, and he had one or two good rock songs on it, but that was it. After that, it was all about love songs, and he's great about it. But the guitar work and the synthesizer work in this song is unbelievable, and it's a wah ball buster. And the guitar work was done by Steve Lukather, and he was the guy that did all the guitar work, and they were great for Toto during the day. So I'm talking about Peter Cetera. Do you remember this? I hope so. You're a rock person if you remember living in the limelight. It's just a, all the way through, it does that. Like, I couldn't wait to play it. Wow. And after that, it was all love songs, which he's great at too. You know. And you think about Asia, and you think about Yes, and the Buggles, and all the offshoot, the law firm, Anderson, Bruford, and Wakeford, and, you know, and all those guys interacted and mixed up and played with different combos, and nobody knows who is in what of those bands, what band members are, except Scott Blubond, who's a friend of mine who worked part-time at WHSL with me in Wilmington, and he knew all about Yes and every one of those guys, and he's seen the shows 159 times, and that's an understatement. I bet I undershot him. I'll bet he's in the 300 range. But I think in Asia, I don't know. I never know. I'm always wrong. I think Carl Palmer was the drummer. And I think Jeff Downs. Scott, am I right? And John Wetton. Okay, maybe those three guys are in Asia. But this was the greatest Asia song to me. And it's a rock song through and throughout. Number niner. Soul Survivor. Yeah. Heck yeah. See, you forget about the great rock songs then, but they had them. You know, so number 10 started off with Peter Cetera, Living in the Limelight, and number 9, Soul Survivor from Asia. Number 1 will surprise you, because it's kind of a joke song, but it's a great rock song on account of the lyrics.